والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا وإمامنا وقائدنا رسول الله محمد. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليك سيدي يا رسول الله. All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, peace and the blessings be upon the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Welcome everyone to Ramadan, the fourth of Ramadan, as you can see, and the fifth night in Taraweeh, inshallah. Welcome everyone participated in the online iftar program with the three communities, the Islamic Center of New Purichi, Dunedin Masjid in Masjid al-Salam in Dunedin, and also Masjid al-Rahman in Tarpon Spring. And as usual, alhamdulillah, we have the honor and the blessings that we have other two imams, mashallah, and we get the benefits from them. Let me welcome Imam Yahya, assalamu alaikum, Imam Muhammad, Imam Masjid al-Salam in Dunedin. Assalamu alaikum, Imam. Assalamu alaikum, Imam Jalal.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my brother. And welcome everybody, inshallah. May Allah bless, ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen, and bless this month. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us the ability to read the Quran and to read the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to attend to the houses of Allah azza wa jal. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your good deed. Ameen
so,
ya Rabbil.
What do you think, Imam Jalal? Ramadan is going very fast. What do you think?
Subhanallah. Allah is the truth. Subhanallah al-azim. Allah, glory be to Him. He is the one who said, ayyaman ma'dudat. It's just a few days. Subhanallah al-azim. Today the fourth, so we have 25 days left, or maybe 26 days left. Subhanallah al-Azim. Oh, just yeah. Yesterday we were celebrating and say to each other, Subhanallah al-Azim, Ramadan Mubarak, and today is fourth. Allahu Akbar. So fast.
Oh, Imam Yahya, get back to us. Assalamu alaikum, Imam.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Inshallah, nice to have you again, Imam Yahya.
Thank you. Jazakumullah khair.
Barakallahu feekum. So inshallah, as we used to talk about the Quranic verses related to Ramadan and related to the virtues of Ramadan, and I believe that everyone, alhamdulillah, today in the khutbah of Jum'ah, lots of people heard about Ramadan, about the virtues of Ramadan. But the verses that we are talking about, the verses that talked about the value of the Quran and what is the reason for the Quran. And as Imam Jalal, inshallah, will talk with us about this part of the verse, Hudan linnasi wa bayyinatin min al-huda wal-furqan, that Quran has guidance for the humanity. And inshallah, we will get back to Imam Yahya so we can hear about the dua, the verse that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said after, right after this verse, Allah said, wa idha sa'alaka ibadi anni fa inni qareeb. When my servants, when my slaves asking you about me, I am near to them. Even Allah did not say to the Prophet Muhammad, oh Muhammad, say to them. Allah said directly, I am near to them and I'm closer to them. So let them just make dua for me. And we will talk today about the importance of dua, especially in Ramadan and especially before the time of iftar. Imam Jalal, please let us know more about that meaning, the Quran has guidance for the humanity.
A'udhu billahi sami al-alim min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, bismillah ar-rahman ar-rahim, wa salatu wa salamu ala ashraf al-mursaleen, sayyidina Muhammad, al-Nabi al-Ummi al-Amin, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim, tasliman kathira. All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek His help and His forgiveness, and we are so happy, alhamdulillah, about this daily, alhamdulillah, great environment that we gather together. And may Allah Azza wa Jal gather us together in paradise. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. And I thank Imam Ahmed Ali for all his efforts. May Allah bless him. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. And put it in his deed into this dunya and in hereafter. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. And as well as also with my other brother, Imam Sheikh Muhammad Yahya. May Allah bless him. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. And everybody attend, and everybody at their houses attends also or do not attend. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Dear respected brothers and sisters, Allah Azza wa Jal said Himself, Allah, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس. The month of Ramadan, the revelation came with the Quran because it is guidance. Guidance to الناس, to all people. Allah doesn't say to the Muslims only or to certain people only. So the Quran to the whole mankind. This is for the whole هدى للناس. You know, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the children of Israel, Bani Israel, this Torah only for them. Torah, it will not apply for us. It cannot be applied to us. It is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if it's correct, of course, but it cannot apply to us. You know, but the Quran, it's for all mankind. Subhanallah al-Azim. And Allah Azza wa Jalla said, إن هذا القرآن يهدي. In Surah Isra, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this Quran, it is a guidance. Subhanallah al-Azim. Also, at the beginning of the Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. This book, meaning the Quran, there is no doubt on the book itself. And there is no doubt that the book is هدى للمتقين, guidance for the whole man, for the whole people who have the guidance. They are the pious people and the righteous people and in their hearts. Subhanallah al-Azim. And inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, I'm going to end with this because I know that the time chasing me. كتاب أنزلناه إليك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the Quran. A book, we revealed it to you. لتخرج الناس. In order to take the people from where? من الظلمات إلى النور. من الظلمات. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about darkness. Not one dark. Darkness. To the light. The light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah bless you, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. And gather us together, inshallah, in Jannah, in Paradise.
Barakallahu feekum, Shaykhana, inshallah. And I can see next to you, brother Muhammad. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him. Allahumma ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. And it is something very important so we can gather together. I can see, mashallah, some people in their houses, someone is driving, someone is running in the street to join the iftar with his family members. I can see, mashallah, Naveed is there. And Allahu Akbar, brother Muhammad Ali, brother Shariq. And so that's the environment that we wanted from. And that is the main reason from that gathering. And alhamdulillah, just I was, you know, thinking today about something very important when everyone came today to the hall so they can pick up the food with the iftar. Alhamdulillah was sponsored today by Dr. Rahim. And on the name and the soul of Sister Afsari, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower her with his mercy, Ya Rabbil Alameen. And Dr. Haider Khan shared with me some of the stories that I was never aware of. I didn't know about. So he told me about his wife, Habiba Khan. And in the 90s, that Sister Afsari and Habiba Khan, they started to make food for the community. And both of them started to cook at their own houses. And they used to bring the food in tents. And they had that desire to serve the community and to deliver the food in Ramadan for the community members. And look at the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And just Dr. Haider, you know, reminded me of the good intention that they had, both of them. And they worked hard for that hall to be built. And subhanallah, here's the days and here's the situation that we have. They went to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but all the good deeds, that's the good intention that they made. They wished something and Allah saw the sincere heart that they had. And you can see right now, people come to pick up the food and we cook inside the hall and mashallah, that is the continuous charity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower both of them with his mercy, Ya Rabbil Alameen, Sister Habiba Khan and Sister Afsari Rahim. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive their sins and shower them with his mercy and let them enter Jannatul Firdaus, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Imam Yahya, we get back to you for the dua, the importance of the dua, especially before the iftar. So what can you share with us, inshallah, before iftar about the dua?
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I start from what Imam Jalal ends when he says, كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليتدبروا آياته. That one of the ways we should handle and we should look at the Quran is to contemplate about the meaning of the Quran. If we just take a look on the verses of Siyam, you will find that they are just five verses. I mean the context of Siyam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu kutiba alaykum siyam. Siyam has been prescribed upon you. And then he says, Ayyaman ma'dudat, just few days. And the third one is, Shahru Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Qur'an, the month of Ramadan where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the Qur'an. And number four, I will save it for now. Number five, Uhilla lakum laylat al-siyam al-rafathu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also is talking about some of the rules related to as-siyam. But number four, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about dua. You might ask, why is it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about dua here? Why is it that verse of dua interrupts the context of siyam? There should be a reason for this, which is whenever you are in a state of siyam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers your dua. It is like a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have this verse here in this specific place. In the context of siyam, it means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond and will answer your dua. Alhamdulillah, it's supported by hadith when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam emphasized and stressed the point that the sa'imi da'watun mustajabatun 'inda fitri, that once you break your fast, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will definitely answer your question, will definitely answer your dua. So take advantage of this moment. And whenever it's time for iftar and time for adhan and maghrib, and once you break your fast, make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask him for everything, and you have this yaqeen, certainty inside your heart that Allah will respond, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُخْلِفُ الْمِيعَادِ, Allah will never break his promise. And, you know, alhamdulillah, this is a great chance that we have 30 days in a row, we have this gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The moment of breaking fasting, inshallah, your dua is mustajab. Jazakumullahu khairan.
Barakallahu fikum, Shaykhana. Inshallah, we will move quickly for the dua, and we are going to make dua for everyone. I can see, mashallah, we have almost like 50 persons, mashallah, on Zoom right now, plus, mashallah, lots of people also. I can see them on the live of Facebook. So that is something very important, alhamdulillah, that we come together for the sake of Allah. And let me remind everyone also, inshallah, tomorrow for the program for the kids, inshallah, we have the program with Sister Jamila, Sister Hind, and Sister Rifat, inshallah, all the teachers. We have the program for the kids, inshallah, at 1 p.m. I send the message and I send the meeting ID for Zoom. So please try to join them tomorrow, inshallah, for your kids, and they will teach them lots of things related to the deen, inshallah. Let's move quickly to the dua, because this is the time that we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our du'as. And I will get back to Imam Yahya for adhan, inshallah. اللهم لك الحمد يا ربنا كما تحب وكما ترضى اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد اللهم تقبل صيامنا وصلاتنا وركوعنا وسجودنا اللهم تقبل صالح أعمالنا اللهم يسر لنا كل عسير اللهم اعتق رقابنا من النار اللهم وحد صفنا واجمع كلمتنا وحببنا إلى بعضنا ألف اللهم بين قلوبنا اللهم توفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين اللهم قبل توبتنا وقض حاجتنا اللهم ارزقنا حبك وحب من يحبك وحب عمل يقربنا إلى حبك اللهم شفع فينا الصيام وشفع فينا القيام اللهم شفع فينا قراءة القرآن اللهم شفع فينا رسولك محمد اللهم نور قلوبنا بالقرآن ونور قبورنا بالقرآن واهد أولادنا بالقرآن واهد بناتنا بالقرآن اللهم اهد نساءنا بالقرآن واهد رجالنا بالقرآن اللهم نور قبورنا بالقرآن اللهم اجعله شافعا لنا لا علينا اللهم اجعله حجة لنا لا علينا اللهم أسكننا به الظلل اللهم أسكننا به الظلل اللهم يا ربنا نسألك أن ترفع البلاء اللهم ارفع عنا الوباء اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا إنك على كل شيء قدير سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خيرا بارك الله فيكم.
May Allah bless you, my brother. It's really great dua. May Allah accept. I mean, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Jazakum Allah khairan.
Yes, brother.
Yes, Imam Yahya.
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا جزاكم الله خيرا بارك الله فيكم جزاكم الله خيرا امام جلال thank you for your time and for sharing the time with us جزاكم الله خيرا امام يحيى for sharing the time with us may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you Allahumma amin ya rabbal alamin dear respected brothers and sisters enjoy your meal and may Allah accept your fasting wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh